Alright gamers, so today this is a different video. If you guys don't remember my last RC car video, it was of the Hazen. I don't really know what it's called, but it's a Hazen RC car, and today we got ourselves a little brand change. We got the BEZGAR, I don't really know what it's called. It says BEZGAR 6 on it, but I'm not really sure. But this is what the box looks like. It's decent size. Yeah, so let's open her up. I think all you have to do is just lift this top up. Let's get into some of the specs that it has though. It has IPX5 waterproof, so IPX5 waterproof is pretty good. My last RC car had IPX4. It's ready to run, four-wheel drive. Just reading it off the box here. Ball bearings, yeah, I don't know, some thingies. And Pippin is playing with my feet. And this just shows the remote on there. So yeah, that's that. Let's open the box up. So I got it all opened up. It's actually a really nice box. I might keep this. I usually keep the boxes anyways, but this is actually a really nice one. So besides the box, we have this little thing that's, I guess what it be, a manual maybe. I'm not really sure, but let's put that aside. And then we got our beautiful controller. I actually really like this controller design. It's like nice and it just looks nice. It's pretty big. Got your steering trim and your speed. Your steering speed right. Alright, I had to cut the video because my brother was calling me. I just realized, as I was saying, this is a turning thingy. On my other RC car, it had like this like little, what'd it be? I don't really know. Rubber maybe, and that noise is Pippin. So yeah, so the steering thingy, it's pretty decent. The throttle feels nice. And I just found out this little thingy, the steering rev, kind of hard to see it backwards, but I'm not sure what the steering rev does, so, yeah. If we open up this part of the box, that's this. So, cut the camera. Yep. So gamers, here we have the RC car itself. This thing actually does have headlights, I'm pretty sure. So yeah, here's the car itself. It's an upgraded version of this other BEZGAR. Feels pretty smooth. So it has these like upgraded pins on it. I don't say upgraded, but these different pins, so they have like these little tabs you can pull, and that, as a RC car user, I actually find that really helpful, because I can just grab these little tabs and pull them out just that easy. So yeah, that's something I find really helpful. But we got the tabs out. Now let's open up this body. It's really clean. Still has the protective thingy, I think, on it. And also, on the top of the body says, "No, please rip off the transparent body film before use." And it just, you know, goes like blah blah and all that. I don't know if I've been sitting back there, but he's doing stuff. So. Right here we have a really nice body, actually. Like this, it's like just all clean. This is the, I forget what it's called, but we have a brush, a nice brushless motor. going to look at the box to see what type of motor it is. So let's look. It is So, I'm not really sure what type of motor it is. I just know I saw it somewhere just a second ago, but yeah, it's a brushless motor, and we got these nice off-roading tires. I really like them. Steering is nice and quiet. The shocks, they feel really nice, actually. Playing around with my foot. So, these shocks actually feel really nice. I will compare them to my current, or my old RC car, I should say. But this is what they are. They're like, they go down, and then like go back up. So I'm gonna go grab my other RC car. Actually, it's not in my room, but it's in the garage. So guys, I'm currently in the garage going to get my old RC car. If you guys don't remember watching this video, I also got this puppy off Amazon. And she kind of took a dump. She doesn't turn on. She's on a full charged battery too. I don't know what's wrong with her. I took her apart the other day. Yeah, I'm not sure what's wrong with her, but the back tires are locked up sometimes. Kevin is really hurting my foot. Ouchies. Ow, ow. So, I'll compare these two RC cars. Here's my new one. You can obviously tell. And my old one. Now, let's compare these shocks. So, this is my old one. Actually, I'm going to compare them to the back, because the back is just better. Because these are more straight, so let's compare both of the back shocks. So, here's my old RC car shocks. Alright, that's... You can already tell that's just, like... I don't know, it's in there. But here's the new RC car shocks. Oh, that's a difference. You can already tell by one, these go down way more. And two, they feel smoother. It's hard to like explain how they feel on camera. They just feel so much smoother. Alright, now let's test these front ones. I think these front ones are gonna fail because I was adjusting these tires like right there and stuff, and they kind of, I did them weirdly, so now they're like that, so yeah. So let's do the front. In the first place, are just hard to get down on the old one. I didn't seem to put this tire back on normally, but. So here's the old one, the shocks just don't feel right. The new one, the shocks feel just great. Here's this. Alright, I want to set this camera up and show how good this actually is. So here's my new RC car. Now that, it doesn't even bounce. And then this is my old RC car. See, there's a difference there, you can already tell. This one just bounced, which is not a good thing. This one, on the other hand, the new one, it did not bounce one bit. So, that's a plus sign. I'm gonna put this there. Almost a pippin. But, yeah. So, here's this. The headlights and all that. Yeah, let's do the box. Let's get more to the box. Alright, gamers. I got this, setup back up. So, the rest of the things that are in the box, we got this little, like, pack, like this little bag. You can't really tell, it's like a, not really know what material, but it's like a little battery pack. I guess you could use this for, like, traveling, maybe, but, yeah, it's good to have a BEZGAR on it. I probably won't really use it, I mean, other than if I'd, like, take it places, but... And here we got the last thing in the box, which is, I'm gonna grab my trusty old knife, which I think is on the batteries, obviously, like the chargers and all that. So, if I can put that on here. So if you do get all this, you can grab out a, I don't know how many volts this is, but it has the bubbles on and stuff because it has to wrap. But yeah, it's an adapter. Not really safe for your RC car. I guess you could just use this for anything. And the next thing that there would be in there is a charger for your RC car. And it has like those like old RC chargers like this on it. Those like RC helicopters have and stuff. So that's, yeah. And then we have another charger. It's the same exact thing. There's two batteries for this. Here's some tools it comes with. It comes with actually extra pins, luckily. So yeah, I'm already starting to like this RC car better. Now we have this. Then we have this little thing. So I'm reading now, it says it takes 3 hours for these batteries to charge. Then we have two batteries, these are for the controller. So I'll put these by the controller. And we have one of the RC car batteries. So these come with two, I don't really know what they are, but I don't know what lithium or something. I think they're lithium batteries. But yeah, we got one of these, and then we got another two. We got one more. So yeah, we got two of these batteries. And go ahead. I think that's about all in the box. Yep, that's about all in the box. So. Yeah, let's get these batteries in, see if these batteries will at least charge, and I'm gonna get these batteries in the controller first, so do that right now. I don't know why I didn't cut the camera, but might not. Let's drop the battery. Now, these are just normal AA batteries for your controller. They're not like BEZGAR batteries or like anything special. So, oh, they go in like this. They don't like lay. So, that's weird, but okay. So, if we put that in, the cap, you don't want to lose this cap, so that's the things on it. So that's one, I say, fault thingy about this, so, yeah, but I mean, other than that, I'm already liking it. Yeah, let's put that back in. Then we have the switch, start the blank. Then I'm not sure if these batteries are charged already, or if they're just, or if you have to charge them yourself, but yeah. I don't really know what to connect this to. I will be right back. Alright, so I found out like where to connect everything and stuff like that, so I'll start connecting right now. Is this right now? The other way around? And is this this? Okay. So I have to get this plugged in. This just connects to the whole battery right here. Yeah, so we got that all plugged in. Can you know what? So it has like a warning sign right there for the motor, but I still touch my motors because I always like to see how hot it gets. So turn it on. Okay, so that's pretty cool. So put the body back on. I don't like putting bodies back on RC cars. It's just, I don't find it fun. So you have to like put the fence in the way. I don't know. I just don't like doing it. Odd reason, I don't really know why. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. I'm gonna cut the camera now until I'm done this. Alright, so. Hold on. This is a satisfying feel. So I'm about to take this, the little protective stuff off of it. You know, that stuff. It's a satisfying feel. Oh, wait. Hold up. No, it messed up. Alright, I'm gonna cut the cameras until I'm done. Alright, so gamers, we are currently. I just got finished unwrapping that stuff, and I'm actually going to put this. Alright, so here's the car. It's true glory. It looks really nice. Yeah, so I think all we do now is just to turn around and hold in this button. Then the lights start to flash. Once you do that. And then I could turn the controller on. Alright. So there it is. She's all locked and loaded. Oh, geez. It already almost fell off the counter, so. Turning seems a little nice, but. I think. What we can do is do this. There we go. Alright, so guys, I'm gonna go get my, tripod, and let's go run around outside. Alright gamers, I got the car outside, so again, these batteries are not really charged, so I don't really know what's, like, you know, it's not gonna go the full speed, unfortunately. But, I mean, it already seems to be going kind of fast. Well, not fast, but it already seems to be working really nice. Oh, let's do this. That had no problem with it. So, let's take her maybe out to the driveway. I'm not really sure. Actually, I'm gonna put her on the grass just like that. There you go. I'm gonna put her right there. You just like, that's like no problem. That goes through it like it's nothing. Oh, well, kind of got stuck. There you go. Well, this thing is four-wheel drive too. If you're ever wondering. Yeah, I don't can never like gamers, that was included for this video. So far, I would recommend this car, but yeah, it's gonna have to take a little bit to get used to, you know. You have to get used to every new RC car. But I don't know. This body is already kind of getting dirty.
Cut. That's tomorrow, and that is it for us today, and we will leave you with a I can't do it.